Let's look at the topic two, that is trends in HRM. So when we talk about trends in HRM, there are various kind of, you know, changes which has taken place in the recruitment. So the first kind of changes which is taken in the HR department itself is many organizations, they maintain a very, very simple and core function of HR, and many HR functions have been outsourced to various other HR consultancies. Say for example, in South India, you have MOFI. Is one of the, you know, major kind of HR consultancies, organizations. They does a lot of outsourcing activity, right from payroll calculations, right from, you know, the you know, maintaining of the entire employee related performance appraisal systems, and you know, the training and development. Likewise, many wings have been taken over by external agencies. So that's the way, actually, you know, outsourcing has become a very, very common kind of a thing. And your own employees may not be into the role of your own organization. They might be, you know, outsourced employee. They might be, you know, employed by some other company, but they will be working for your company. That's the way, actually, you know, today the trends in recruitment is happening, and outsourcing firm develop their human resource pool by employing people for them and make available personnel to, you know, various companies as per their needs. And that's the way, if you look into it, outsourcing firms or the intermediaries charge the organization for the services. That's the way, actually, you know, you need not, you know, probably look at employees, you know, on the full time. You can also look at from the outsourcing point of view. The next one is a poaching and raiding and e-recruitment. Poaching and raiding is nothing but means employing a competent and experienced person already working with, you know, another reputed company, especially your competitor or probably the benchmark company, whoever is a market leader. Try to contact them and poach them. Try to, you know, probably recruit them into your organization by paying a higher salary or probably any other thing, especially in the difficult kind of, you know, different industries and all, they will follow this. And company can attract talent from another firm by offering an attractive pay package and, you know, different kind of terms and conditions. And another kind of, you know, method or a trend which is picking up is your, you know, e-recruitment. You know, entire recruitment is happening online today. You have a job portals like Naukri.com, Monster, and TimesJob.com is giving a lot of kind of an avenues for both job seekers as well as the job provider to, you know, probably look into the kind of a way the recruitment happening today. So there are direct contact has been established between, you know, probably the employer and the prospective employee by e-recruitment. It's a kind of a technology which assists in, you know, probably the recruitment process. So now let's try to look at the other trends. So 360 degree kind of a feedback. So as we already discussed in the previous topic about the performance appraisal, 360 degree is nothing but we try to assess the employee performance based on various kind of factors. It's not only one person does it. Whichever people whoever is involved in the entire you know, transaction with the employees, they will be assisting them and they will be, you know, rating them. So HR department has to look at all the rating and, you know, they need to assess it properly. That's again a major kind of a challenge. And the next one is a leadership development. Actually, if you look into it, you know, today the leadership talent, actually, you know, it's very key for a business future growth. So that's the way, if you look into it, companies like HUL and Procter & Gamble, they have, you know, been able to withstand the attrition in key executives because they have been invested in developing a leaders in the organizations, and leaders have been empowered and they have been asked to, you know, take an important decision making. So leadership development is also, you know, one of the important kind of a key area. So again, how HR manages these leaders and empower them and trying to, you know, provide a best kind of, you know, work environment, that's again a major kind of a challenge. And other than that, you know, even the needs of an employee is also keep growing. One side, if you look into it, people are saying that work-life balance, they doesn't want it to stretch the work beyond the time because they wanted to spend quality time with the family. So that's a way, actually, if you look into it, work-life balance has become an, you know, kind of a thing, and quality work-life has become an, you know, another major challenge. And instant kind of a reward, customers, you know, the employees are expecting. So that's a way, actually, recognition and compensation, and both in terms of monetary as well as non-monetary, and work-life balance programs and competency pay packages and career opportunities, all this thing we need to, you know, keep looking at it. And the other one is their exit policy. Exit policy is nothing but, you know, surplus manpower is a major problem in many industrial units, especially in the manufacturing unit and public sector units and all. So exit policy refers to the policy, how we try to, you know, retrench the surplus manpower. from restructuring, by restructuring the entire industrial units and the workers, you know, becoming an unemployed by the closure of the sick units. So it covers the compensation for an employee who leaves the organization, and we need to look at how we can do the rehabilitation of those kind of an employees also. So that's again a major kind of an, you know, trend which is picking up. And other kind of trends is your golden handshake and you know, national renewal fund. The golden handshake is nothing but as per the executive employment contract, that provides the executive with a significant package in the case that the executive loses or her job through firing or restructuring or a retirement. So there has to be a compensation has to be done. So especially in the public sector units and all, this kind of, you know, method was adopted during 90s, where excessive employees have been forced, you know, sent out from the organizations, and they have been given with the heavy cash and equity and other benefits. The other one is the National Renewal Fund. The central government of India has established the National Renewal Fund. It is basically for the benefit of the worker, because when there is a restructuring or any change or modernization happens or closure of the units. So that's again an exit policy. And another one is our golden handcuffs. Golden handcuffs are nothing but it's a kind of a system of financial incentives designed to keep an employee from leaving the company. And it's basically a special kind of a package has been given to them, and highly compensation has been provided to the top level leader, so that, you know, the leader does not stay in that particular organization for a long time. And the other one is a golden boot compensation, is an inducement using a maximum kind of an incentives and financial benefits for a older worker to, you know, take a voluntary retirement. So this has also happened at the, you know, public sector units. So these are the ways actually, you know, trends which is picking up in human resource management.